Here we are, Long Island, New York, Barasechet Bava Batra, Tractate, the well-known Mishemet, Perek Chi'i, page 149. We start with 148, two lines from the bottom of the page. Matnat Shechiv Nmera, the gift of someone who is about to die, is the core discussion. We explained in the past that we differentiate between Yerusha, meaning inheritance, and the gift. Here we are with the question when it's come to a gift, how far you go, especially if a person gets better. The first one is the subject of different language, of different expression. Amar Rav Sheshet, he told v'yizkeh v'yachazik v'yikneh, kulan leshonot hanayim. If someone said before his deathbed, a different language that the interpretation, it's about to say the same idea. Obviously, a person in his deathbed is about to die. He's not always have the speech capability of expression in a clear way, so we assume, as the Rabbeinu Yonah and Ritva explained, that he intent to give it. So again, as far as the matana, as far as giving a gift, it's okay. We're not speaking about inheritance, which is a different expression that is close to the Yerusha, but so it means all these languages applies to Rabbi Yochanan ben Broka, and as we explained earlier, if you remember, it was in several places, we said that we follow the halakha according to Rabbi Yochanan ben Broka. Iba aya lehu. 149, yehane bahem mahu. So if you talk about Mr. So-and-so, should have a benefit for my estate. The neve kulo matana kamar, or dilma li tane minay umidye kamar. He intend to give him as a gift, Rabbeinu Gershom said, is the same as he gave in a way something that he have some type of benefit because he gave it as in a structure of a gift, or he intend to say you have some benefit, some joy at the temporary time, but not a matter of acquisition. Again, it's sometimes that people express themselves and it's not clear, it's ambiguous. Ya'amod ba'em ma'u, yisha'en ba'em ma'u. So all these different languages, it's unresolved because it's not clear when a person said so-and-so shall benefit from my property, if he intent in his expression to really hand it over the estate or just talk about temporarily benefit. So as we said, amotzim echavero, if the a person wants the burden of proof rest upon the claimant, and that's the way the Rambam in Chod Zchiyah Matanat chapter 9 said, as well as Shulchan Aruch Choshen Mishpat 253. Ibaya lehu. Here is another subject. We are page 149, four lines from the top of the page. A person gives the right to other people to acquire his estate, meaning is a regular matter of sale. However, the question is how far you go. The Ritva elaborates, and he said you have to know that it must be ma'aseh kinyan, must be a matter of acquisition. Otherwise, expression of sale when it's come to a statement uttering, it's not sufficient when it's a person in deathbed. So ibayelu machar kol nechasav mau, can he retract that when he gets better, which happen sometimes. So here we see different directions that contradicted each other. Amaravud amarav imamad eno chozer, vizimnin amaravud amarav imamad chozer. So how come? It's two different statements contradicted. One said that he can retrieve it, and the other one said no. Velo plige hal de itnehu lezuzei be'einayhu ha defarinu bechovo. You have to differentiate between the money is there, so he can retrieve it, retract the sale, or if he paid off his debt, so it's done and it's over, he cannot retrieve it. Ibayelu shchimera shehoda mau, meaning that he expresses his, he made a statement that certain estate that was in his property, it's not his. Do you say that it's something that you take it seriously, or you just want to make sure that the sons will not interpret it as a wealthy people? We learn in Tractate Sanhedrin, page 29b, that if a person just make a statement that he owe money to other people, you cannot go by that statement to go ahead and acquire. So he will bring a story about a fellow that converted to Judaism, but it was the issue of the time. So Tashma de Isur Giyorah, his name of a person who converted to Judaism, named Isur. Hava le Treisar Alfei Zuzeh b'Rava. He have 12,000 Zuz by the house of Rava. Rav Mari Brei, his son, or Ato b'Gidusha, Ato b'Gidusha Ava. That's a common situation when they have the cohabitation and the baby the mother was conceived, the father was not Jewish, he converted to Judaism, the baby at the first stage, meaning when he was a fetus, he wasn't Jewish, later on, he is part of the Jewish faith. So the question is, as far as the inheritance, in a sense of father-son, it's not applicable in this case. Bei ha-rav hava amarava, heich nikniu rav amri la-rezuze, how you'll be able to acquire this money, ib ki birushala bayrushayu. We explained that since this matter of a acceptance of Jewish faith happened, the transactions and the acceptance is two different things. It happens two different times. The earliest time that the father and the mother were together and have the baby wasn't Jewish. And later on it happens. So in a sense, as far as the inheritance is not considering quote-unquote par se son, when someone is a deathbed and giving a gift, the sages compare it to a matter of inheritance. So as long as the estate can follow the law of inheritance, you can put it under the structure of giving a gift of someone who is a deathbed. So therefore, since Isur was a convert, so convert, he cannot inherit it because the estate of his father was not Jewish, and as we explained many times, it's like new soul born. So since it was in that statement, you cannot transfer it in a regular manner of structure of Matnat Shchimera. So obviously there is a Ravid in Shita Mekubetzet Yad Ramash that elaborates a lot on that. We just give the structure the way that the Rashba explained to us, as well as the Ran. Ibn Mishicha, if you make it in a matter of acquisition by pulling it, that money is not by Isur, so therefore he cannot give it to Rav Mary to take it as a collateral. If you make it in a matter of exchange, Kenyan Sudam, that's what we learn in Tractate Kiddushin, page 28. This is a matter of coin or exchange of money, cannot go by the Kinyan Suda. So they said, Agav Karka, if you take it by the Kinyan Agav, which we learn in Kiddushin 26, that applies as well as money. We learn also in the next Dav, 150. So he said, Lately Ar'a, he doesn't have the estate issue. So the question is, it's mind-boggling, the Ritvayin, the Mukhei Yosef, and the Ramban said, how you do it, Ibe Ma'amad Shloshtan, if you make the three entities that there, that the person who deposit, the person who receive it, and the person who is the total reception of the gift, that's basically the structure of the three people, the Rashbam explained. He said, Ish alach lei lo azlinan, if he sent it to him, he will not go there, because otherwise he will lose it. The whole idea is that without the presence of the belly, he cannot transfer the ownership of the money. So here, Matkif la Rav Ika, Bar Bred Rav Ami, Amai, why we say that that Isur cannot transfer to Rav Mary, Velo de Isur de Halein Zuzei, the Rav Mary Nin Hu, so Veliknu be Odita. So the way he can do it, he transfer those dinar that he owe by Rav Mary, and he shall transfer the ownership of them to Rav Mary by means of document admission. So that's they call the odita, kinyan oda'a, meaning the expression. And that we said many times, so that ba'din kemeh edindam, it's the same as 100 people come and express it. So it's a disputation, Tosfot Rosh said with the Magen Dovid Rishonim, how far you go with the definition of odita. Some say that it's ma'ase kinyan, the same as sudar or meshicha. Others say that no, the Rimi Gash said that the Birkei Yosef also in Choshen Mishpat Mem, it's a question how you do that. The Ksotza Choshen concluded in Kuf Tzadik Dalet in 194 that it's all depend upon the expression that he made. But Ikfad Rava Ve'amar Kam Migamrei Tantali Ninsheyu Mafsidilei. He was kind of angry, Rava gets, and he said, they are teaching people legal claims and causing me loss. So here you see a situation that the incidents proves that the admission of a person on his deathbed is valid means of transferring ownership. And it's not only to think that he is concerned about the wealth that people take for his son Tosfot. In the Dibur Matchil Shchiv Merah, challenged the whole concept of transferring ownership of this mine. But again, the way that Ksot HaChoshen expresses this all depends upon our investigation and our best understanding of what happened in his mindset at that time, which is a very kind of sensitive time because it's a time of a deathbed. 149b, Shier Karka Kol Shehu Matnato Kayemet. The Mishnah said on page 146b, if he left the one on the deathbed reserved for himself any amount or some type of land, so that gives stand if he somehow all of a sudden recover. So the question is, Vekhama Kol Shehu, what do you mean by saying something, any amount? So he said, Amrav Yudam, Rav Rav Karka Kedei Parnasato, he left an estate that gives him the capability of need for his livelihood. So he reserved certain land for himself. We assume that he wished to transfer the rest of the property in any event. Rav Yudam, Amar Metaltini Kedei Parnasato, any movable property that he needs for his livelihood, that's considering a gift. So the Rosh said, for example, a person that he is a merchant, so he left that some movable estate that he can have benefit from the profit. Amar Rav Zera, kam mechavnim shma'ateta desavei, how much is the important statement of this Amoraim, which means kol shehu, which is kedei parnasa, the Rashbam said in karka, but also movable property, metal telin. Karka tamem demai, because he figure out if he get better, so you have something to make a living. Movable property as well, he relying upon his for his livelihood. What's so exact in this ruling? V'adetnan, what we said in Tractate Pe'ah, Chapter 3, Mishnah 8, Hakotev kol nechasav le'avdo, if someone put in writing, gives to the document his property to his Knanite slave, yatza ben chorin, so it basically is not his servant, he reserved for himself any amount of land, and he is not been he has been emancipated, but the thing is she'er karka kolshu lo yatza ben chorin, if he left as a gift excluding karka kolshu, so then for he is not emancipated because we assume that he left the slave for himself as well. That's based on the Gemara in Kiddushin, page 22b. Rabbi Shimon Omer, Rabbi Shimon said le'olam hu ben chorin. He said that always become a freeman, no matter what the exact wording of the document, even if the owner reserved land for himself, unless it says clearly, lucidly in the document. Ad sheyomar, kol nechasai netunim lefloni avdi, all my estate is giving to my slave, Mr. So-and-so, chutz me'echad meribo shebaem, except for one, 1,000 of it. So here you see a possibility that the owner meant to include this servant in the portion that he is not giving away. So as a result, you see that slave is not emancipated. And you see more on that in Rashi, Tractate Gittin, page 9, page 150. V'amar avdimi bar Yosef amar Rabbi Lazar, asu mitatlin shiur etzel eved, ve'lo asu mitatlin shiur etzel ketubah. He said that the sages deem movable property to be considered a significant reserving a property for oneself with regard to emancipating a slave, but not that movable property when it's come to a marriage contract. Because if one give all of his property to his sons, but reserve any amount of land for his wife, she forfeits her marriage contract. Obviously, as we said many times, but the person is not protesting the gift. She's concede that she will collect her marriage contract only from the land that he reserved for her. So as you see here, if you reserve only movable property for his wife, she does not forfeit marriage contract. Anyway, hatamu bedin, bedinu delo litnei karta. The truth is the Mishnah should not mention land by the Tana Reisha, because the first part of the Mishnah used the term karka, Rabbi Akiva omer karka kolshu, even a small part of land, chayevet bepeah ubikurim. They are obligated to have the peah, which is the obligation to have a corner, and also the mitzvah of the first fruits. And if the dealer possesses any amount of land, the creditor can ולקנות עם הם נכסים שאין לאחריות בכסף ובשטר ובחזקה. So a person can use that those metaltelin by money, by deed, or by taking possession of it. Just for those who are not so familiar, the mitzvah of Peah, it's in Leviticus chapter 19, to leave the corner for the poor people. The mitzvah of Bikurin is Deuteronomy 26, speak about the mitzvah of the first fruit. And as far as the Shimut Alva'ah, that's from Deuteronomy 15, speak about the loan that, as we learn in Tractate Gittin, page 36, that Hillel left the Presbul for the people who's taking advantage of taking loan and not paying it in the way it should be. So the Mishnah in Shvit, chapter 10, said that it's go by the court system. And therefore, as long as the borrower have an estate, the presbul is effective, and the other fellow cannot take advantage of the fact that it is a sabbatical year. So the Gemara said, "Mishumachetane karka." So that's the reason why I mentioned the Mishnah teaches that the halacha is regard to the land. So what Rav Yosef proved here, the language of the Mishnah, "Shiyer karka kolshu," he left some estate. It means kolshehu. And it's not necessarily kedei panasato, but he responded and said, sometimes not in the literal sense, kol shehu, v'chol lecha detane kol shehu, late le shiura. You mean to say that when he said a general, any amount, it means that not have any measure? ואתנן רבי דוסה בן ארכינס אומר חמש רחלות גוזות מנה מנה ופרס חייבות בראשית הגז. Here is the Mishnah interactive Chulin, page 135. So they, when shearing five sheep, the shearer wool of each sheep with the wool weighing 100 dinars and half of 100 dinar, which is 150 dinars. So render the owner obligated the mitzvah of the first shear wool that given to the priest. That's Reshit Hagez. It's a mitzvah that the Torah expressed in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 4. והחכמים אומרים חמש רחלות גוזזות כלשהן ואמרים על כמה וכמה כלשהן. So they said that five sheep, and he said, is any amount? And we ask a question, what do you mean by any amount? אמר רב מנה ופרס ולבד שיהיו מחומשות. רב said that is 100 dinars and a half, was that as long as these 150 dinars are divided equally between the five sheep. So you see here that you have the term kolshu, which is any amount, can denote a certain minimum amount. So Rav Yosef rejected, said, "Adam bedin lo nitne kol shehu." Over there in Rashi, I guess, so the Mishnah really should say in any amount. V'ad kamar tana shehu rabba amar anu shehu zuta. Since the Rabbah mentioned the large measure, which is the first statement, so therefore the sages also speak about the small measure, and therefore karele kol shehu. So we call the measure any amount. So you see here, when you speak about the gift a person given a deathbed, the term amount should be understood literally. So obviously, as we see, the conclusion so far is that we brought the elder Amoraim, which is Rav Ravir Miabarava, that when he said karka koshu, any amount of state, it's not necessarily bedavka, it can be in the way that we fulfill the gift of someone who's in deathbed when he turned to be better. So you have to go by kedei parnasato, but something that it's a minimum amount for him to continue make a living, and it's enough to have a metaltelim, a movable property. Rab Zeira praised this rule of the elder, and it means that it's all depend upon the view of the person who is in deathbed, that he figure out that will be sufficient money for him to survive for the rest of his life. Rav Yosef hold that it's not matched Lashon HaMishnah, because the Mishnah said karka kolshu, any amount. Abaye respond that here we speak about different Lashonot, different way of expression of estate. Karka kolshu, it applies to both movable property or a certain amount. Rav Yosef rejected it. All this example that Abaye brought, he holds that is a special reason for Tanakhama to bring and use these languages, but it's not necessarily exact way. The Mishnah said that kolshu, not necessarily in the literal sense. Later on, we're going to, in the next shiur of Mitzvah Shem, going to bring the final halacha when it's come to this type of disputation.